Home Assistant 2023.11 is around the corner, or it is already released, depending on which time you are watching this video. But nevertheless, here are the most important things that have been delivered. In Home Assistant 2023.11, a new to-do entity has been introduced. This entity represents a list of tasks and its states indicates the number of tasks that are still open. Now you can add to-do lists directly in the Home Assistant sidebar. This list can include both local and cloud-based lists, including shopping lists. This is possible because Home Assistant integrations can now provide to-dos since they're considered entities. Additionally, the recently introduced shopping list is now also considered a to-do entity. But there is even more to it. The new feature opens up opportunities to check the state of these tasks using scripts and automations, and add additional logic to them if needed. It is important to know that if you have a to-do list, integrations can utilize it as well. This means that you can now seamlessly integrate Todoist and Google Tasks to-do lists into Home Assistant. These lists will be visualized as another to-do list within Home Assistant. Essentially, you can now have both Google Tasks to-do lists and local to-do lists running concurrently. Tile cards are having so much attention lately that made me believe that they will soon become the main cards in Home Assistant, and why not with drag and drop functionality added. Anyways, Home Assistant 2023.11 release makes no exception, and it gives the tile card another portion of love again. Because now it is possible to create custom state content for the tile cards. That means in the tile cards I can define the state line by myself. That can be done super easy by editing the tile card from the user interface and selecting a preferred state content from the appearance section. On top, I can combine several states in one line just as easily. I can add every attribute and I can order them the way I want. And that works for all supported entities like lights, switches, climate, and so on. Imagine how much more useful info you can add to the tiny tile cards that way. Saving screen real estate and adding value at the same time is great combination, don't you think? Matter 1.2 is adding 9 new device types, fixes some stability issues, and have a lot of improvements across the board. But this is not the most interesting to me thing here. The most interesting is that Matter 1.2 release was announced just several days ago. There are no Matter 1.2 devices yet, but nevertheless, Home Assistant 2023.11 will support that latest version of the Matter standard. It is so fast. On top, look at that statement in the release notes, which is basically saying that a lot of Matter device makers are using Home Assistant as a playground because of the good Matter support. And they are testing their devices on the Home Assistant Matter controller before all others. That is really good news for all of us, as Home Assistant is becoming more and more mainstream, and we can expect all future smart home and IoT devices to work flawlessly on it. If you didn't join the fun yet, now is a great time to start your Home Assistant journey. And if you need a little help getting started, join my totally free webinar, where I'll talk about the official ways to get Home Assistant, some pros and cons, and I'll share one super simple way to start on a PC in under 5 minutes. Link and QR code to the webinar registration can be found on your screen. Next, in Home Assistant 2023.11, the Energy dashboard now have a date picker from where a custom date range can be selected so that the energy usage can be seen for just specific period of time. Nice little touch that can help a lot comparing different periods or catching a trend. Next, Conditional Cards allows you to wrap another card and put a condition on it so that the card of interest to be visible only if certain criteria is met. For example, show a card only if the sensor is available and hide it otherwise. From Home Assistant 2023.11 and onwards, instead of just one condition, I can define multiple ones. So that makes the conditional card even more useful. But there is even more. 3 new conditions are added, and these are user, numeric, and screen conditions. Applying user condition on the conditional card allows you to show or hide different cards depending on the logged in Home Assistant user. The numeric state condition allows you to show or hide cards based on the state of a numeric entity. And the screen condition allows you to show or hide cards based on the screen size of the device you are viewing Home Assistant on. For example, you can hide some cards when Home Assistant is opened on a smartphone or a small tablet. The coolest thing here is that I can combine all of the conditions the way I want. For example, a certain card can be shown only when I'm logged in and when the temperature is below 20 degrees and if I'm opening Home Assistant from a mobile device. Next change is small, but it is worth mentioning. There is a restart Home Assistant in safe mode button now, which will start Home Assistant without loading any custom integrations and front-end modules like themes and custom cards. That can be super useful if you're willing to troubleshoot and debug so you can fix some strange performance or front-end issues easily. Next new feature is added possibility to set up improved devices directly from Home Assistant. Improved is an open protocol used by firmwares like WLAD, Tasmota, ESP Home and few others that help with Wi-Fi configuration of your newly flashed devices. The Wi-Fi configuration happens over serial or Bluetooth once the firmware is uploaded, eliminating the need to switch back and forth to and from the device hotspot that is usually created for initial configuration. What is new here is that if you now buy or get from somewhere a Wi-Fi and Bluetooth enabled device with ESP Home installed on it, this device will be automatically detected and you will be able to configure and join that device to your home network and your Home Assistant instance very smoothly, and all the hard work will be done transparently for you by the above mentioned improved protocol. Have in mind that this functionality is only available on ESP Home firmware at the moment, and WLAD, Tasmota and others may or may not join the party in the future. From Home Assistant 2023.11 and onwards, if I create a script, I can add my own fields to that script. For example, I can create a script that have a custom text field called notification. Later on, I can call the script service and I can pass a text for that custom text field named notification, and that script can send that text as notification to my phone. That way, I can use one script for multiple purposes. Defining these custom fields is happening through the Home Assistant UI, where you can define name, variable, key name description, selector, and default values, as well as is the field required or not. New country selector for blueprints or for the above mentioned custom script fields is also added in Home Assistant 2023.11. Again, this selector is configurable from the UI and the countries in the selector can be limited to whatever set you wish. Some more stuff is added in 2023.11. Namely, variable type checking in templates. In other words, the template engine now have the ability to check the type of a variable, so some additional logic can be added if the variable type match or not. If you are writing templates regularly, you appreciate this, I believe. But there is even more noteworthy changes in this release. That new two-pane view that you saw in the to-do list is also available in the calendar dashboard. ZHA is even smarter now. If it senses any changes in your network settings, it will shoot up a repair issue that can help you get back on track ASAP. The Fitbit integration got a makeover. Now you can set it up right from the user interface, and it even supports Fitbit nutrition sensors. Event entity support is now added to the FiberO integration. And last but not least, the HomeKit bridge is on it. It will handle changes in device capabilities and add remove devices all by itself. We have some new integration as well in this November release. We've got Google Tasks on board. Now you can easily access your Google Tasks to-do list right from the brand new to-do dashboard. Improve BLE, we talk about it. It makes connecting your improve enabled gadgets to your network a breeze. Local to-do list, we talked about that as well, allowing you to create and handle your very own local to-do list right here in Home Assistant. You can now integrate a Tami water bar if you have such a device, and you can boil water and keep an eye on filter sensors. And to-do list as entity, we talked about that as well. Don't forget to check the breaking changes in the release notes, as well as my smart home glossary if something is not quite clear for you. Thanks for watching, I'm Kirill, and until next one, bye!